going to turn it into a newspaper story.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm not kidding you.
We're going to call a meeting to order of the Hampton Municipal Budget Committee. We have a couple of details that we need to take care of before the public hearings begin. So at 6, whatever it is up there, 6:32. 6:32, we're starting. We will do the Pledge of Allegiance when we get to the public hearing. Okay, I need a motion.
Madam Chair, I'd like to make a motion. To pass the total, grand total for the town budget. I did this on Thursday night. Mary Louise called for a vote, but it was never recorded properly. So the total is $26,836,977. Do I have a second?
A second.
Okay, seconded by Mr. Henderson. Now, this is because basically a whole bunch of people got talking and we forgot to confirm the operating budget for 2017 for the town of Hampton. So that was Mr. LaBranch. Our secretary is not feeling well this evening, so she will take the minutes from the TV. And Henderson was the second. Okay, you understand the intent of the motion. We're confirming the bottom line figure for the town of Hampton 2017 budget. In favor? I'm trying to see everybody down there. Can I see hands?
In favor, that's the budget.
Oh, Mr. Pierce, you're kind of blocked off. Are you voting?
I'm waiting for the no.
Oh, okay. All right, Mr. Jones, what are you doing?
I'm waiting for something other than yay.
Okay. And Jenny, I just can't, hands? Okay, we have Bridle, Rage, Kravitz, Henderson, and Pluff, and LaBranch, and Danielle Augustine, and Jenny Bridle, school rep. Okay, opposed will be Pierce, Lapham, and Jones, and Maurer, and Woolsey. Okay.
Just
and no
tally
extensions.
On that.
Beg pardon?
Just a tally on that?
That's what I'm going to write down now. I've got...
You're not the chairman?
Excuse me?
You pointed out to me in the last meeting.
Just count.
Okay, and
just count.
And we've got Rage... and Kravitz and Pierce and Lapham. Well, I'm going right up the line. And Henderson in favor. Pluff. Yeah, well, this is in favor and these whoops in favor. I don't know. Okay, and then LaBranch, Augustine, and I got Jenny Bridle already. And so opposed is Pierce and Lapham and Jones and Maurer and Woolsey. I'm going to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In favor, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's an 8-5.
13 member committee.
And that's approved.
That's if they're all here.
Now, do you have anything else that you can think of that we need to address before we start the public hearing of the school?
Yeah, we have to look at the CBAs because they were modified.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
I say we have to look at the CBAs because they were modified.
A collective bargaining because they were modified. Mr. Pierce, please use the microphone or those poor men will go crazy. Okay, we're going to take a look at the money articles. And Christy has, Mr. Jones, the side talking is driving us nutty. Okay, not that we're already not nutty. The money articles are... one of the pass outs that you just received. Now, you want us to revisit the CBAs.
And I have a question on all four.
Okay, so that starts with Article 15. Local 2664.
Madam Chair, I'm happy to talk about them, but I don't want to revisit them. Just so that's on the record, I don't want
that.
I understand the argument.
The calculations.
I just stay in my position, and that's it. I don't want to say any more on the topic.
Now, Christy, on the calculations here, and I just want to see what I need to get to 15. These chairs are awful. I think I'm sitting on the floor. Okay, now we've got the sum on 2664. So that's 93,968. We'll have to address these one by one.
It's here.
So what is your comment?
Well, my question is on the warrant articles themselves, when you look at a spreadsheet that was passed out just the other night, there's savings of like $43,000 on the 17 CBA, and there's $82,000 on the next one, and there's another amount on the third and fourth one. And I'm just wondering if the grand total shouldn't be adjusted to take those savings into account. Because these numbers are in the warrant articles, are the same as what the sheet says at the just about the cost and so forth. It doesn't include the cost savings, so to speak. I'm just wondering why the cost savings weren't subtracted from those totals.
Christy, could you help us with that? Or Jamie, yeah, whoever.
So there's not to hear the question?
Okay. Well, it looks like from the pass-outs that we got.
Was it the costing sheet as I was asking?
The
savings aspect?
Final.
Yes. I just couldn't hear you. You were asking why that wasn't subtracted off the other number?
Yes.
Basically, we looked at what we costed them on. It was basically the new money on the expense side versus the savings we have. But we felt it was just consistent with what we did transparency before. We didn't subtract it off. We showed that as what the savings will be from the health care is the best estimate we have right now. But we didn't deduct any of those other numbers off of that. We had what's the new expense. Basically, we asked that question you had from last year. What's going to cost us for this contract? And that's what we put it in.
So if the
committee wishes to do that, I'm sure there'll be no objection from the board. We just wanted to be as accurate as we could with what the new cost was. And we wanted to put out there what savings were so folks can take that into account.
I understand what you're saying, I think, but it leads you to believe by the spreadsheet you were passed out, there was going to be the $43,000 would be subtracted from the total, for example, on the first one, which is the 37.
I think you can make that argument if you want to. Again, we focused on what the costing was going to be for salaries and benefits, much as we did before. And this year we did negotiate savings. We did not deduct that off of that top because the costing is what's that new salary, what's that number for that side of the ledger where we went for. We're going to realize potentially those savings in those years. Sure.
Madam Chair?
Yes, sir.
And Jamie, is this the way we've always done it? By adding the cost in and not...
Yeah. We have any never... savings in like health care, any of that stuff has never been costed.
You know what, Jamie? Before. You need the microphone, come to think of it, because we want to pick you up. So, Jamie,
so the question was... Mr. Bridle was, is this the way we costed it before? My answer to that is yes.
Okay, now, so as we're looking at in the first article, 2664, the firefighters, you've got the compounded cumulative cost impact over the three contract years of the agreement is estimated to be $762,451.
Correct.
That's your final figure for that contract?
Yes, ma'am. That's our estimate for that.
Your best estimate for that contract?
Yes, ma'am.
And the same for 3017? We're showing
$330,758. Correct.
17, the Teamsters, $323,732.
Correct.
Okay. And?
SEIU.
Yep, and then for the Public Works, SEA, what the heck is the Oh, there it is, $534,042.
Those are the same figures, Madam Chair, as these.
Well, I know, but we got confused because it's showing savings here on the health stuff, if you look on the bottom.
I know, but look, see, this is the number right here? It's right there.
I get it, but we're looking, this is extra savings.
Oh, okay.
We were looking to see if the savings were incorporated.
They are not, because we haven't included them in the past, but we felt it was important for people to see that.
Okay.
That costing sheet is up on the website with the TAs for everyone to see. We thought it was important to have both sides of that in there.
Okay.
However, it's never been included in what our costing is that we put out on the warrant.
We didn't realize that, and that was confusing.
Right. Now, I think, if, not to speak for Mr. Pierce, but one of the reasons you folks are revisiting this is, since the last time you took a vote, there were some questions raised. We went back and looked at it, and primarily it came up in 3017, because that number just looked big for a unit that isn't that huge.
Yes.
And what we found was an error in our spreadsheet that had been left over. Basically, one of the numbers in there was compounded twice. And that was a good find, and again, we appreciate the committee's pointing that out again. We went back and checked our formulas and found that there was a problem there. Then we went back and looked at the others as well, and again, we looked at the compound accumulator. What you see is that number for a compound accumulator on your spreadsheet in front of you of anything that's basically salary-related.
Yeah.
We did not compound because the annual is going to get a $300 or $500 for education incentives.
Mm-hmm.
Those don't compound year to year. It's a one-time payment.
Okay.
So what we did was take anything related to salary, take a factor for overtime because it's related to salary, cumulatively compounded them, and then added to that number the new one-year costs.
Yeah.
Then on the sheet you see that the public has, we reflected the savings so that they see those two sides of that.
Yeah. Okay. We had about a week to get our heads around understanding it. And I was confused, I admit, by the health stuff on the bottom.
Okay.
Madam Chair.
Yes, sir.
I want to thank Jamie for pointing out that the Budget Committee was of use in this area, and openly acknowledging public that we did add value as a Budget Committee.
As
so I thank you,
last
Jamie.
Last year, as one of your members pointed out on the gas issue,
that's correct.
Saved the town substantial money.
And I very much appreciate it.
Once
I'm sure the whole Budget Committee appreciates
it. Once in a while, you win.
We try all the time.
So do all of us.
That's right. That's exactly right. We appreciate it.
Excellent.
All.
Any other questions, ma'am?
Thank you for the clarification. You comfortable, Mr. Pierce?
I'm all set. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff.
Now, what time is it? Okay, we're getting close, but we still. Now, does anyone else have any other issues or motions to bring up before we commence the public hearing? This is just housekeeping that we're doing right now. And I'll close this work session at 6:45. Okay, I'll accept a motion to close this Budget Committee work session prior to the
I'll make that motion to close
public hearing. Mr. LaBranch is making the motion to close. Mr.
Jenny
Clough
is.
Well, you get a lot of you running around here. And Mr. Clough seconded. In favor of closing the public meeting?
Yes.
Okay, I think I've got
it's unanimous.
Unanimous, excellent. Okay, you're free until 7 p.m. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to start the public hearing, and we're going to have a nice, quiet audience, right? Right. Okay.
So I'm in a perfect job.
We're going to call.
No, because that's my job to be paying.
Enough. We're going to call the public hearing of SAU 90 budget and warrant articles. So this meeting for the public hearing is called to order at 7 p.m. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we're going to have the members of the Budget Committee introduce themselves to you, starting on the viewer's right. Chuck?
Chuck Rage, representing the Hampton Beach Village District.
Sonny Kravitz.
Mike Pierce.
Brian Lopham.
Steve Henderson.
Mike Bloch. Stephen LaBranch.
Danielle Augustine.
Jones.
David Maurer.
Ginny Bridle, school board representative. And we're glad we have her here tonight. Okay, great. Ginny, why don't you walk us through? We have the paperwork from your business administrator, Mr. Lunny.
Good.
And it says proposed fiscal year 2017-18 warrant. I just want to make the public... Hey, noise in here, guys. We want the public to understand that the school is not a calendar year budget. The school budget runs July 1 to June 30 of the following year. Okay, thank you, Ginny. You got the microphone?
Yep. Move Article 1. Shall the Hampton School District vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $25,950,000. Boy, they'd like it if the first figure was true. For reconstruction and equipment of the Hampton Academy Middle School.
Second.
And authorize the issuance of not more than $25,950,000 of bonds or notes in accordance with the provision of the Municipal Finance Act. And authorize the school board to issue, negotiate, sell, and deliver such bonds or notes, and to determine the rate of interest thereon, and the maturity and the other terms thereof, and to further raise and appropriate the additional sum of $570,360 for payment of the first year's interest on bonds or notes authorized by this article, and authorize the selectmen to, the school board to apply, accept, extend any grants or other aid for this purpose, and take any other action necessary to carry out this vote. The school board and the budget committee recommend this appropriation. A three-fifths vote of the town meeting is required.
Right, this is a bond issue, so it requires a three-fifths majority. Who seconded?
Me.
Mr. Lapham, thank you. Okay, is there anyone in the audience who wishes to speak to this article? We are not working on this evening. We are presenting it to you so we can get your feedback. Does anyone wish to say yay or nay or comment? There appearing to be no comments, we'll move on. Ginny, please.
Article 2. Shall the school district raise and appropriate an operating budget, not including appropriations by special warrant articles and other appropriations voted separately? The amount set forth on the budget posted up with the warrant as amended by the vote of the first session for the purposes set forth therein, totaling $20,635,850. Should this article be defeated, the default budget will be $20,679,275, which is the same as last year, with certain adjustments required by the previous actions of the district or by law, or the governing body may hold one special meeting in accordance with RSA 40 to take up the issue of a revised operating budget. The school board and the budget committee recommend this appropriation.
Okay, may we have a second? Seconded by Mr. Plouffe. All right, back to the audience who have come for the public hearing. Anyone in the audience wish to address the school operating budget figure July 1st, 2017 to June 30, 2018? Anyone? Okay. Ginny, if we may go on to Article 3.
To see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $300,000 to continue long-term maintenance, repair, and modernization work to include technical and or engineering services at Hampton, Marston, and Center School buildings and grounds. This article is a continuation of the annual program plan to keep buildings updated and in good condition, therefore protecting the taxpayers' investments. Projects planned for 2017-2018 are listed below. This is a non-lapsing appropriation per RSA 32:7-6 and will not lapse until these projects are completed or June 30th, 2019, which is ever earlier. The school board and the budget committee recommend this appropriation. At Marston School, we will replace the roof over the original building, annex and kitchen for $230,000, replace original classroom sinks and countertops, $15,000, implement security improvements, $15,000, for a total of $260,000 at Marston. Center School, replace original classroom sinks and countertops, $15,000, ADA improvements district-wide, $5,000. Roof repairs are ongoing, and it's $5,000. And implement security improvements, which is $15,000 for a total of $40,000. That gives you the $300,000.
I would second that motion.
Seconded by Mr. LaBranche. Okay. Is there anyone who wants to address this article? Art Brady and Mike Edgar started this routine every single year, $300,000 maintenance article, and this has been in place since 1986, and it's done a lot of good work to maintain our schools. Any questions or comments from the public on Article 3? There appearing to be none, we can move on to a private petition article, which is going to show as Article 4.
Article 4 is to see if the school district will vote to raise and appropriate funds in the amount of $39,729 to provide child benefit services in accordance with RSA 189:49 for students who are residents in the Hampton School District and attend Sacred Heart located in Hampton, New Hampshire. The school board and the budget committee recommend this appropriation, and there are two people representing Sacred Heart who are available to answer any questions.
Excellent. If Mr. LaBranche has seconded. Ladies, or one or both, are you welcome to come up to the microphone?
Thank you.
Once again, a private petition article.
Hello, my name is Teresa Morin Bailey, and I'm the principal at Sacred Heart School. First, I would like to thank all Hampton residents for past support and continued support of the CBS funds to Sacred Heart School. Presently, we have 41 Hampton students at Sacred Heart School, 29 elementary and 12 junior high school students. Sacred Heart has been a part of the culture and history of Hampton since 1962. It has been a part of the educational system within the town. Over the past years, we have established a supportive relationship with the Hampton School District. There is professional collaboration between teachers and administration. We include each other in professional development opportunities for all teachers, collaborate on curriculum programs, and we open up our summer programs to all Hampton residents. We are asking for $39,729. We divide that, our per pupil cost is $968.99. And we divide that throughout for the nurse, educational technology, supplies, and instructional materials and textbooks. The above totals reflect a 2% increase per student and an overall decrease of 12.8% from last year. Last year we had 48 Hampton students that we asked $45,600. This amount is based on this year's student enrollment of 41 students. I appreciate your support and your votes. The CBS funds will not be used for any religious purposes. I thank you for your time.
Wait, could you just clarify for the public the legislation that authorizes this to be presented is intended to give to the parochial school students services or things that they could not get on their own, so to bring them up to what the public schools provide.
Correct, and that's, as I told you, there were four components that we asked for. Our nurse, we asked for $14,000. Educational technology, we asked for $18,729. Supplies, $2,000, and instructional materials and textbooks, $5,000, and that's based on the per pupil student
right
cost.
Excellent. So it does vary from year to year, predicated on the number of pupils.
Yes, it does. Absolutely.
Great. Thank you. Yep. Does anyone have any questions on the committee? Any? Okay. Thank you very
okay,
much.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Would you like to come up? Oh, okay. Okay.
Madam Chairman,
yes.
I am now going to pass the MS-27 for the school district. I would ask each budget committee member to print on one side, sign on the other, and when it gets down to Regina, just hold it, I'll pick it up for you.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
I'd like to move to close the public hearing on SAU 90.
Second.
At what hour?
Right now.
off well.
7-Eleven, just like the store.
The clock is sort of a neck twist away. Okay, moved by Mr. Jones?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Jamie.
Okay.
Seconded.
Seconded by Mr. LaBranche. Okay, in favor?
Unanimous.
Okay, unanimous. Excellent. Okay. Thank you very, very much, everyone. And please, would the viewers at home, as well as the nice people who are here, please inform yourselves on the renovation budget for Hampton Academy. It is a really, really important program, an important undertaking, and we will appreciate your support.
Madam Chairman, there are bumper stickers, there are signs, and there are buttons available. Either stop in at the SAU 90 office, stop by Village Preschool, stop by any member of the committees.
Amanda Cooper at the library will also have items on display.
Bumper stickers, buttons?
Bumper stickers. Stickers.
Stickers and buttons?
Yes.
Both and pro and con?
We have no. Pro. Friends of Hampton Academy bought this.
Thank you.
I didn't ask about them. I just wondered where you had the whole spectrum covered or not.
Well, I guess if they want anti, then they could see you. And
that
see
would, that would require the enemies of SAU 90, right? Oh, of course not.
Okay, that's great. We thank the school board members. We thank Superintendent Murphy and our wonderful teachers and principals and vice principals and
the
Mr.
wonderful
Lund.
Technology director, Greg.
Yes.
We shouldn't forget him.
Yes.
Thank you for getting the fiber optics, Greg. Great, great news.
And Mr. Lund.
Hopefully the town will soon be following that.
Who's a great administrator. Okay. Now, we're still passing this down, ladies and gentlemen. And then I will start. There we go.
Madam Chair.
There's two of them there.
Madam Chair, I move to open this. Madam Chair.
And then sign. Oh, okay, the budget form, the MS-27. Okay, here you go. The MS-27 and the MS-7. Oh, they're both 27s.
Ginny,
yes.
there are two copies,
and they're both
MS-27.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay.
And they can all be signed after the meeting. Madam Chair?
I give this to Ginny, and then we'll collect them at the end. Wait
Madam
one
Chair,
second, we'll start. Yes.
I move to open the public hearing on the town's warrant.
Well, we will in one second. We want it. People will be distracted. I just want to get this down and sign quick. Yeah, we're going down there. Give us a breather. Nathan, thank you so much for your hard work. We appreciate working with you.
Whatever inefficiency can be introduced, we will introduce it.
You can do meditation right now.
I don't have my computer.
Ginny, we can bring him a prayer rug.
That's right.
Do you?
Yeah, I know, but I
No, 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 you have to, this is the second. There were two. You have to sign each.
That's for the budget. Did you sign it?
Yes.
He didn't sign the first one.
Okay.
Well, do you want David? Does David want to sign it?
David, do you want to sign the second copy?
Yes.
All right.
I know.
I wasn't at that meeting, remember?
It's hard
I wasn't at the meeting.
No, I work as a commercial lending.
Oh.
So I manage a portfolio of investments.
Oh, okay.
How's the market going? Up and down and up and down?
Rates have certainly increased since the election.
Yes. They only require a majority signature.
That really gets you.
Yeah. I used to work for TV. I worked for TV for 6 years.
What are we doing? We're holding up the whole public hearing. Give me the
gun. You are right. We can do this after the meeting.
No, we're going to do it now so we don't forget it. Jeez.
No, my door is still open.
There's a motion on the table. I'm looking for a second.
Well, if you don't have a second, sit there and look cute for a few minutes. And then we'll
I can't
get
look
to you.
Cute, but I can smile.
Oh, God. Okay, sign, and then we need to give those to the superintendent. Yes?
Okay, I will second Mr. Jones's motion.
Thank you, Mr. LaBranche.
We haven't got the second document yet.
At 7:16 p.m.
Okay. Moved by Mr. Jones. Second by LaBranche.
7:16 p.m.
We're going to open the public hearing on the Town of Hampton warrant. And there are money articles mixed in. We have $200 million. Yes, I agree with you. Well, we need to do the...
Do we have a designated town reader?
Wait a minute.
You can take turns, I think, if you'd like to.
Well, normally the town manager does, as far as asking.
Oh, is the town manager going to read them?
No, I don't think so.
Jim, you want to start?
No, I don't.
Wait. Okay. Starting with...
You want me to make the motion on Article 10?
Starting with the money articles, which is Article 10, and the pass-outs are over there. It's coming, Kathleen, it's coming. The first, Article 10, is the Church Street Force Main. You have, I hope you all have your packets from the table.
Madam Chair.
Yes, sir.
I move to public hearing. Article 10, the Church Street Force Main. And further ask that it be considered read as written.
Seconded by Mr. Plough. Okay, now does anyone have any questions? Anybody here from Public Works? Yes. There, Jennifer, my dear. Would you come up just in case there are questions? And when we are at the deliberative session on February 4th, Public Works will have big diagrams for you so that you can actually see how the project will work out. Up there, my dear, in case. I know. I'm making you walk all over. This basically is to replace the two wastewater force mains because we had a leak in one of the force mains in the winter of 2015 to 2016, and that puts sewage all in the marsh, and the state of New Hampshire said, don't do that. Jennifer, you want to give a super quick explanation?
Super quick explanation is that the project is for the relocation of the existing two force mains that are located under the marsh to provide us with a new force main system that is accessible, that we'll be able to clean, that will be sized for future growth, and that will be located under land, not the marsh, so we can get to it if there ever another issue.
Okay.
The longevity of the existing ones have reached its point, and it's time.
Do you have questions for Mrs. Hale, anyone, on the project? Okay, they're appearing to be...
I'm at one, right here.
Oh, thank you.
The new line is going to be beside the road, beside the highway?
It will be. It'll be in the shoulder of 101.
Okay, there we go. Then we can proceed, Mr. Jones, if we may, to Article 11, the Lafayette Road Sewer.
Yeah, Madam Chair, just a point of order, if I might.
Yes.
We are here to listen to the public, that's it.
Right.
So we don't need to call people up. We can let them come up on their own, make comments, or ask questions as they wish.
Okay.
We don't need to make commentary about it.
And then we'll have people respond.
Until after the public hearing, we don't need to make any commentary whatsoever, nor describe anything.
Okay.
Madam Chair, I move Article 11 to public hearing for the Lafayette Road Sewer and ask that it be considered read as written.
Seconded by Mr. Henderson. Okay, you understand the intent of the motion. Anyone have any questions about replacing the sewer line on Lafayette Road?
Or commentary.
There appears to be none. We will move on to the next money article.
Madam Chair, I move Article 12, Asset Management for Stormwater and Wastewater Assets, and ask that it be considered read as written to public hearing.
Okay. Seconded by Mr. Plough. Questions or comments from the public? Hearing to be none, we will move on.
Madam Chair, I move Article 13, wastewater treatment plant energy audit, to the public hearing and ask that it be considered read as written.
I'll second.
Seconded by Henderson. Any questions or comments on Article 13, the wastewater treatment plant energy audit? All right.
Madam Chair, I move Article 14, the budget, to public hearing and ask that it be considered read as written.
I'll second.
Henderson. Okay, the operating budget. Do we have any questions or comments on the Town of Hampton operating budget? We did confirm the figure, $26,836,977 proposed for this year. Okay.
Madam Chair, I move Article 15, Professional Firefighters of Hampton, IAFF 2664 CBA, to public hearing and ask that it be considered read as written.
I'll second.
Any question on the professional firefighters collective bargaining article? Okay.
Madam Chair, I move Article 16, Hampton Fire Department Supervisory Association Local 3017 CBA, to public hearing and ask that it be considered read as written.
I'll second that.
Henderson seconds. This is a fire officer's contract. Those wishing to comment? No. Okay. I thought I had a yes over there. Okay, no
Madam
comments,
Chair.
No questions. Okay, Article 17.
Madam Chair, I move Article 17, International Brotherhood of Teamsters Local 633 CBA, to public hearing and ask that it be considered read as written. Good night, Kathleen.
Second.
Good
night.
Mr. Pluff seconds. Okay. These are the Teamsters, the miscellaneous positions within the town. Any questions? Okay.
Madam Chair, I move Article 18, State Employees Association of New Hampshire, Incorporated, Local 1984, CBA, to public hearing and ask that it be considered read as written.
I'll second.
Henderson. Okay, this is the State Employees Association, Local 1984. Any questions? Any comments? Okay.
Madam Chair, I move Article 19, to public hearing, paving highway block grant, and ask that it be considered read as written.
Mr. Pluff seconds.
Yep.
Highway block grant. Comments? Questions? Okay.
Madam Chair, I move that Stephen LaBranche make all the following motions on the remaining articles.
Article 20, DPW vehicle purchases.
What was that fancy wording you were using?
For consideration.
Can we do it one more time, Steve?
Wait a minute. Consider it read as written. Do I have a second?
Yes.
I'll second.
Okay, I've got two of you. Who's
Henderson.
Henderson. Okay.
I'm too shy.
Purchasing vehicles for public works. Comments, questions, problems? Okay.
Madam Chair, I move Article 21, Road Improvement Capital Reserve Fund, to the public hearing and be considered read as written.
Second.
Okay. Questions, comments?
Madam Chair, I move Article Sidewalks for public hearing.
22.
Number 22, I'm sorry. For public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Second.
12 seconds. Those of you who get excited about sidewalks, any comments, questions? All right.
Madam Chair, I move Article 23, Household Hazardous Waste Collection, to public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Mr. Flood. Okay. Questions, comments on the household hazardous waste collection?
Madam Chair, I move Article 24, replace Bicentennial Park seawall, to public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Second. Henderson seconds. Questions, comments from the public?
Madam Chair, I move Article 25, purchase used fire engine pumper, to this public meeting, a public hearing rather, and to be considered read as written.
Mr. Henderson. Questions? This is your fire department. Questions or comments on this article?
Madam Chair, I move Article 26, human service agencies, to this public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Seconded by Mr. Clough. Questions or comments on the human service agencies article?
Madam Chair, I move Article 27, Recreation Infrastructure Special Revenue Fund, to this public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Yeah, I got you. Yeah. Okay, any comments or questions about the Recreation Infrastructure Special Revenue Fund?
Okay. Madam Chair, I move Article 28, Police Forfeiture Special Revenue Fund, to this public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Okay. Henderson, anyone want to comment or ask questions on the police forfeiture special revenue fund? Okay.
Madam Chair, I will move Article 29, add windows to the children's room at the library, to this public hearing and to be considered read as written.
Second.
Seconded by Henderson. Okay, and do we have anyone with questions or comments?
Over here.
Yes. Excellent. Yes, please do.
Thank you. My name is Chris Singleton, Hampton resident, 14 Great Gate Drive. Speaking in support of Article 29, the appropriation for three new windows in the children's room in the library, I had a chance to check out the scope of the project and the location of the windows in the basement in the children's room. I would ask the Budget Committee to consider this in that it appears that obviously it'll provide more light, a better environment in that particular room. I know they're doing the best they can with the location in the basement. I think there are two other things that jumped out at me. One is circulation of air. What I noticed in that basement in the library, it's a historic building in my opinion, but that basement does not provide a lot of circulation. So I think that those three windows certainly will add to that. Given the fact that we have children down there, senior citizens, you know, it's very important to help enhance that particular situation. And then I also understand that one of the windows will provide an emergency exit. And I don't need to go into detail about what's been going on in the world today. But I think that to have another emergency exit, that alone to me jumped out. Safety, our children, our senior citizens. So I appreciate you listening. I would ask when you get back into session after the public hearing, if you could please reconsider this vote. I saw it was a 6-6 tie, and I think there are 13 members on the committee, right. And I believe you're all here tonight. So I would ask your consideration. Very much appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris. Oh, Keith, good evening.
Good evening. Keith Lessard, 173 Mill Road. I would encourage the six that did not support this article to reconsider it. I think it's very important to provide adequate emergency routes out of the public building. And I think that natural light is very important for the kids. I don't know when the library will ever be renovated. And this is something that we should bite the bullet and vote in favor of installing the windows in the lower level for egress and for natural sunlight. Thank you.
further questions or comments from those present? Hearing none, we'll move to...
Madam Chair, I will move Article 30, Conservation Fund, for this public hearing, or to this public hearing, and to be considered read as written.
Second.
And for second. Any comments or questions on the Conservation Fund? Okay.
Madam Chair, I will move Article 31 to this public hearing, electronic storage of town records, to be considered read as written.
Second.
What second? Okay. Any comments on the electronic storage of town records article? Okay.
Article 40, Madam Chair, I move Article 40, Christmas Parade, to this public hearing for comments and to be considered read as written.
Okay.
Point of order, Madam Chair.
Yes, sir.
This article has recommended by the Board of Selectmen 000. Recommended by the Budget Committee 000.
Where's Regina? Where did she go?
I think we have a flaw.
I just can't see
somewhere.
Yeah, I'm right here. I believe we've already voted on this, I think, last Monday.
This is not
the Christmas parade? Oh, did someone help me?
The big
one. Oh, yeah, this one.
Not the articles alone, Rusty, but on your handout, you have it.
Yeah, it shows 5-0 in favor and recommended by the Budget Committee 13-0.
Correct in sadness.
This is
yes, yes, that, we've got that. But this one just didn't show it.
So the handout that we have for the Budget Committee to review at the public hearings is incorrect and we should not use
it. It's incomplete.
Yeah. Well, incomplete means incorrect.
Hold on. There are two of them, Tim. She gave us the actual warrant.
I understand.
And it's there.
Can I finish my sentence?
Go ahead.
So apparently we should use the full warrant, which is this guy right here, right?
Yes, it's correct in there.
So I just wanted to highlight that to anyone who's confused that they have the other one. You want to use this one?
Same thing, Madam Chair.
Enough said.
Okay, comments or questions from the public? Okay, we have the same problem on Article 44, but we'll find that quick.
Okay, seeing none. Madam Chair, I move Article 44, Reconstruction of Lafayette Road, for consideration at this public hearing for comments, and be considered read as written.
Madam Chair, this one has the same problem, not only in one document, but in both documents.
Oh, both documents.
Madam Chair, we actually just voted on this warrant article at 7 o'clock tonight, so the vote was 3-1, I believe, for a recommendation.
44.
Yes.
Okay, then we'll have to bring this up.
Did we vote on that?
We voted on that. The Budget Committee has already voted.
The Selectmen voted on this long ago. I mean, I thought.
This, we just received this article. This was the last article we received.
Oh, this is a last-minute experience Hampton one.
I think it was after our...
We've never seen this before.
So what was the selectman's
vote? So this is something we should have taken up in our public meeting.
It was 3-1. We just voted tonight on it.
With no... okay.
We didn't know it.
Rick's not here, so...
Zero. Okay, then we'll have to vote on this as well. And there are only three items. Any questions or comments from the public on this Article 44, which is the last one?
Madam Chair, may I read the entire motion, since this is the first time that the Budget Committee has seen this? Okay. Article 44, Reconstruction of Lafayette Road. On the petition of Experience Hampton and at least 25 Hampton registered voters, shall the town of Hampton vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $300,000 for preliminary design services for the construction of Lafayette Road from the area near the intersection of High Street south toward Winneconnet Road. The design services would include street, sidewalk, utility, and lighting improvements for the downtown Hampton Village in an effort to revitalize the downtown. The preliminary design would be used to support a future project that has the potential to be funded by the Road Improvement Capital Reserve Fund, created under Article 16 of the 1998 Annual Town Meeting, in accordance with the provisions of RSA 35
for the purpose of maintenance and or reconstruction of streets. Said appropriation to be offset by a donation by Experience Hampton, estimated to be no less than $30,000. This article is contingent upon the donation of no less than $30,000 from Experience Hampton and the donation's acceptance by the Board of Selectmen. This shall be a non-lapsing appropriation per RSA 32:7 Roman numerals 6 and shall not lapse until the project is completed by
or by
March 31st, 2018, whichever occurs sooner. Majority vote required. Recommended by the Board of Selectmen 3-1-0.
Right.
Fiscal impact note. The estimated 2017 tax impact on $300,000 is 0.091 per 1,000 valuation.
Okay.
Madam Chair, procedural question.
Yes.
Are we doing the public hearing on this now?
Well,
or are we,
in order,
are we going to be taking a budget committee vote first? Before?
Wait a minute. In order to bring this to the public hearing, we need to have input. So, well, because we're going to have to take a vote and then ask for input and then see whether or not we confirm the vote.
So to do that, Madam Chair, you're suggesting we close the public hearing, go back and do a public meeting, and then reopen the public hearing?
Let's say we recess. Let's recess the public hearing
right.
at whatever hour. What's up there?
Okay.
Oh, 7:38.
Thank you. 7:38 p.m. Okay. Mr. Jones, seconded by Mr. LaBranche, is calling for a recess in the public hearing so we can have information on Article 44. Regina, or whoever you designate, somebody talk.
I would like to identify Mr. John Nine.
Okay.
Good evening, John Nyan, 2 Walnut Avenue, Hampton, New Hampshire, also president of Experience Hampton. First of all, I apologize for not having this warrant article in earlier, but I might add that we did get it in on time.
You did. Yeah.
And that if I can just take a few minutes to explain.
Mm-hmm.
This article, in all essence, fits a piece of a puzzle that is in a very bigger strategy that the town of Hampton, especially Public Works, is working on right now with the downtown area. If you recall, back in 2012, 2013, there was a charrette done that really examined the downtown area and came up with a number of recommendations of how to improve our downtown. Since then, Experience Hampton has kind of taken the private approach to work with the town in looking at small economic development projects to work towards some of the recommendations from that charrette. If you recall, back in 2015, we did the pathway between the parking lot and Lafayette Road, and that was our first project. That project was the first of what we call our 2020 strategy, which was created in memory of Mrs. Tinius, who wanted folks to really work towards improving the downtown area. So Experience Hampton took on that task to look at a 5-year strategy plan on how we could improve downtown. The second year, 2016, we donated to the town of Hampton money close to $6,000-$7,000 to put in 2 crosswalks, one at across from the Galley Arch and one up near Rambic Funeral Home, mm-hmm. as our 2016 donation. But as we started to look at what the Public Works was doing in terms of the overall strategy of downtown, and the overall strategy being defined as water, sewerage, and then utilizing, hopefully, the CIP money to do new roadways, sidewalks, lighting, et cetera. One of the things that we have talked about with Experience Hampton and the Board of Directors and also the business community down on Lafayette Road is that how can we participate in that strategy, that overall strategy? And one of the things that we are recommending and working very hard to accomplish is the actual either removal, replacement, or burying of the utility poles from the Galley Hatch restaurant to High Street. So Winnicott to High Street. In order for us to do that and to continue to work with Public Works, it's important for us to come up with funds that would be what considered design services that would identify the actual cost of those utilities, whether or not we move them someplace or put them underground. That is where we came up with the $300,000 number. We have worked over the last couple of months with Unitil, who has been the primary utility involved in the telephone poles downtown. We have also brought in their partners, including Comcast, Fairpoint, etc. And we realized that in order for us to move forward on that effort, we need the engineering design, if you will, to be funded to make that happen. The Board of Experience Hampton realizes two things. One is that we, as a private volunteer organization, would like to contribute to that effort, and that's where you see the $30,000 contribution within this warrant article. And that, I might add, is a minimum of $30,000. If we can continue to work in terms of our fundraising and seeking private donations, that $30,000 could increase, which would then lessen the amount that the town would have to pay for those design services. But the bigger picture is that we're looking at how do we go out and fund. Let's assume for a minute, and I'm just throwing out this number because we don't have a hard number until we get that design service number. But let's assume for a minute that that effort to tie in with what Public Works is doing right now is anywhere from $2 to $4 million. We are prepared as a board, and we have the authority and within our bylaws to do this, to go out and secure state and federal funds to bring to the town of Hampton to cover the cost of having that done. We have no intentions whatsoever to come back to the town 2 years from now and say, okay, we have now found out through this warrant article that it's going to be $2 million. And now we want a warrant article for $2 million. It is not our intention, nor do we want to do that. So that it's our effort that we already have some folks that have volunteered within the community to be our grant writers and to go out over the next year to secure the amount of money that it would cost to have this effort done. What all of this does is brings all of these small projects and into one big project. So now we're looking at a project of really renovating and redeveloping downtown infrastructure. We're talking water, we're talking sewerage, we're talking sidewalks, road repair, we're talking utility poles, etc. So what we're hoping for is a complete picture. Some of you might have heard the term complete streets. We're working towards that effort to make downtown a very friendly, residential area. And we feel very confident that, as we have seen down on the beach, that if we can improve the infrastructure of Lafayette Road in that area, we'll also improve the business community and the residential community in that area. So once again, I apologize for the late warrant article, but I would ask for your support in this effort to get it in front of the voters of Hampton. Okay. I'm more than happy to answer any questions.
Okay, just hang in for a minute, and we may need Chris Jacobs as well. Mr. LaBranche has a question. Questions from the board.
This committee.
Committee, I'm sorry. Whatever.
This, I have to ask, and I'm not sure if I should be asking Chris or John Nyan, probably both of you, because I'm going back to Article 11, the Lafayette Road sewer project. That was explained to us, excuse me, that was explained to us, and Chris, if I'm wrong, please correct me, that you were going to dig up the and replace the sewer pipes, that you had coordinated, I believe, with the gas company, and they were going to replace the gas pipes. Is that correct? Or was it water? Okay, water then. Because the point that I'm wondering about is that you're going to, if Warren Article 11 passes, then you are going to proceed to start digging up and replacing. And the only thing I'm concerned about, I guess my question is now to John Nyan, is that it's going to be all done at the same time. For instance, we're not going to dig this road up, change the pipes and stuff, and then a year or two from now, you get these grants and we dig the road up again to bury telephone lines and electric lines. Am I correct in saying that it'll all happen at the same time?
Well, yes, but let me clarify what same time means.
Okay, please.
The discussions that we've had with Aquarian Water is that they can move forward this spring of 17 and replace the water lines.
A little louder, Chris.
Replace the water lines. And by the way, I did watch this from my office, and 99% of you, we can hear. We can even hear Jamie Sullivan when he stood in the middle. He does not need a microphone. But anyhow, so the water, we would proceed this spring of 17. I would look to proceed with a construction contract, have it in place for the sewer replacement in the fall of 17, after pretty much the seafood festival, because I don't really want to be the one to disrupt the summer community down there. It would be in the summer of 18 that we would look to the gas company could do any work that they may have to do, and then we would also follow up with the drainage. We get done that, and there isn't going to be much in the way of pavement left. So I was looking at the fall of 18 to resurface the road, full width, realign any catch basins I needed to have realigned, and also do any sidewalk improvements. And it has been mentioned that, you know, it would be nice to continue the lighting theme, at least one similar to what was done down A through F streets down at the beach. All in favor of that. When, you know, and I have to say that I, as a public works director, I'm very, very pleased to see a private-public partnership. Sometimes we operate in a void, but we do what we think is right. And it's nice in this instance, Experience Hampton's been very, they do what they say they're going to do. And they represent a large portion of the business community. And if it's the business community and therefore the taxpayers, directly or indirectly, that want this done, then we're more than happy to do it. And I would, as you've said, only like to be in there once and be done with it. I don't want to be putting years after years of people through pain. So if I can get this done in two construction seasons, I'd definitely like to do it. And that comes back to why this Warren article. I have the design money for the sewer. I don't have to spend any design money for the water. Drainage is, water runs downhill. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure that out. We've kind of got the basins. You know, we have grades that we have to work off of. I have additional drainage issues down there to improve on, but it's relatively straightforward. What isn't straightforward is how to make that streetscape, how to make it a complete street, how to make it more livable, more walkable, more without at the same time making, you know, an obstruction to traffic. And that's where Experience Hampton comes in. It takes a while to get all that in place and then to be able to consider that. And through the construction process, I wouldn't have the time or the staff to do that and do it justice and have it come out something that everyone would be really pleased with. So that's where Experience Hampton comes in, and that's where why they put up a portion of the funds. And all they did is consult us on the framework or the wording of the ordinance, and I kind of knew it was coming forward. But so it doesn't run over my toes. It doesn't double engineer or double design anything. Matter of fact, it's a very complementary component, and I would hope that everyone would see it that way. Yeah. Thank you.
An additional question would be, this isn't going to change the intersection at High Street and Lafayette, or the intersection at Winneconnet and Lafayette in
not,
any way.
Not the geometric portions.
It will not change
not
the
at
intersection.
All. Matter of fact,
okay. Just the work, road in between.
Right. At the south end, we drew a line between Dana's Towing and...
the gas station.
Well... not really the casting, we're just a shade north of that, the Kenny Bunk project.
Okay.
And although when we are on the north end at High, we have one utility pole that we want to address on High that we keep clipping with a snowplow. And we're looking probably to find a way to backfeed that through the High Street lot. So so that's about the scope.
Yeah. And when they put the electric in conduits under the ground, and then it's up to each building owner to bring it into their building?
There's probably a 200-page volume of PUC rules that addresses that. Mm-hmm. It has to do with the size of the load, whether it's commercial or non-commercial. The project, when we design it, is going to, I would think, pick up 100% of that cost. In other words, not burden the individual property owners with, for instance, happen to move a meter and then pay for it. We look to work that out with Unitil, and that's why one of the suggestions is, let's see if we can feed the buildings from the backside, i.e. down from the High Street parking lot, versus, let's say, digging up the park and the sidewalk. So they've done this before. I mean, we're not the first chicken on the road. Concord's done it. Laconia's done a portion, a number of other communities. So there's ways of doing it reasonably, with less pain, and cost effectively too.
Yeah, because not everybody, everything along that area, not everything is commercial.
There's at correct. Least there's a lot of residential.
Yeah, residential
right.
as
right.
well. So
yeah, definitely.
So that you're figuring to that'll be included, putting them online.
Yes, definitely.
Okay, I understand completely. I think, Chris, thank you very much.
Yeah.
There's a couple of major projects on the ballot. Oh, okay. A couple of major projects on the ballot. I was wondering whether you can include biking or hiking, a biking lane while you're resurfacing.
The Complete Streets program does speak to that very strongly, too. Have safe bike lanes, and also that's what we'd be looking at the sidewalks for, is safe walking paths and the crosswalks.
So there's, on 101.
Exactly. So there's a lot of that, and that's really what this Article 44 speaks to, is incorporating those types of things into the design.
Mm-hmm. Microphone, Michael.
I have a couple of questions. Are you planning on presenting this to the public, like seminars or something like that, when we did the various projects before?
Yes, it would be when we have something to present, because right now it's merely just 1,000 thoughts floating in the air, and that's what part of this money would be used for, is to bring it to something that could be envisioned. What we're talking about is using a portion of the money to actually develop 3D plans where people could see what they would be buying. What would the complete street look like? Mm-hmm. This is in an effort to get the business community in that corridor to understand and to buy into the project, and also for the voters to understand. Like, for instance, when it comes to appropriating that $1.5 million, if they choose to do so, what it would be used for and what the end result would be. So, yes, there has to be more outreach.
I would think so, but just starting off with the $300,000, I've seen many plans before in Hampton where they spent a chunk of change on planning and we never did do it. So
I'm reluctant to be enthused about the $300,000 without any public exposure whatsoever until this point in time. I think it's a little late. It's like the train has already left the station as far as I'm concerned for this year on this issue. Well, I mean, it's kind of late to try to come along and say at the last minute, oh, by the way, we got this wonderful plan. Well, that's wonderful, but I think the public needs to be informed on that plan. And I haven't seen anything until just tonight.
Well, as I said earlier in my comments, is that when the water company finishes doing what they're doing, and we do the sewer, and I redo some of the drainage because I'm dealing with some corrugated steel pipes that may be in their corroded state or not, there won't be one table square of pavement that's untouched. So I have to do a full width pavement. I have to make it right, make it look good, make it look better than it presently does. I've got some sidewalk deficiencies down there. So given the amount of work that's going to go on in that corridor, there's no way possible that this would be a boondoggle or a waste of money or time or effort. It would actually make the project wrap it up tightly and make it come out better in the end, in my opinion. But Mr. Nines.
Yeah, go ahead, Chuck.
Can I make a comment before? I know everybody thinks that I only talk about the beach, but the beach and the town go hand in hand. A vibrant downtown and a vibrant beach work well together. In Hampton Beach, we had every street torn up, all new sewer lines. We spent millions of dollars, and that was the time that we should have put a lot of the utilities underground. It's unsightly, and it's never going to be changed now. And I think at this point, this is a great move forward for downtown. We should definitely jump on this. It'll save the town a lot of money in the future by thinking ahead of time. So I think this is great. And any concern about Experience Hampton getting the word out there, I don't think we have that concern. We know Experience Hampton, whenever they put their mind to doing something, it gets done. And I think this is a great, great article, and I think everybody should move forward with it.
Okay, Mr. Plouffe has a quick question.
If this goes tandem with the sewer article, and the sewer article doesn't pass, we'll still do this and have it waiting for perhaps the sewer to come back next year, and just delay it a year, or would this, is this a year ahead of time? Some of the reconstruction of Route 1 from the center up towards the Northampton line, there was a lot of discussion about burying the electrical and everything that's in this for downtown. And the I was on the board, but I don't remember all the details. It was 99, the actual paperwork was put through the state. But at that time, the electric company said that it would be cost prohibitive to take the poles down and connect, like where Scott Pontiac used to be and Hackett Chevrolet. All those buildings had three-phase power, and the cost to take that down and bury it and then make the private businesses connect was astronomical back then. And I don't know, as there's an awful lot of difference with this proposal here, except that it's not as long, and there are less power requirements than there were in the north end. But is this a year ahead of time, or is this premature because we don't know about the sewer article? If that doesn't pass, this is going to sit, and so is that.
Great. I feel it's almost like this is kind of like a presidential news conference with a number of questions on the floor. So let me take the first one first.
Yeah.
If the article to replace the sewer does not pass, the water will probably still proceed. So
yeah.
Northbound lane side of the road will be disrupted.
Yeah.
I will still have to disrupt a portion of the south side because I have a section of clay pipe that, as I explained in the presentations the other night and a couple of weeks ago, is it's missing. gone. So I'll be in there digging up a portion just north of the Dunkin' Donuts. How far up the street, I don't know, until we get in there and dig it up. So a portion of the work would definitely go through. Would I then bring warrant article back through? Yes, because it doesn't change the fact that it's a 1934 pipe, right, severely cracked, and probably giving me a lot of infiltration into the line and probably losing some sewer water. So that won't change that. If this passes and the sewer fails, what would end up happening is the engineering would proceed forward. And because what we've heard from the other communities is you can't take enough time to do it. This is not, that's why when you, I first got up here and you said it'll be done, in, you know, all at the same time. In a lifetime perspective, yes, it'll all be done at the same time. I won't be going in there every 5 years, but it is a multi-year project. And it will give us time, a better time to plan it out, see what it's going to look like, control our costs. As far as the electrical, we're just digging into it. It doesn't sound like much has changed in the electrical side, except you are right. There's not as many three-phase or any, to our knowledge, any three-phase users this far south. And but different than the north end, there's ability to move some of those utilities on the back side of the structures. We're on the north-north side, we're parallel to the railroad line, and we can use that. That's currently an undeveloped portion of land. But easements would have to be obtained, et cetera. So we may not actually, in the terminology, we keep saying bury the poles, but understand, we're not burying a 60-foot pole 60 feet down. We're burying the lines, we're just getting rid of the poles. Right. Okay, along the street. Thank you. I hope that answered it.
Yeah. Madam Chairperson.
Yes, sir.
Can I just make one response? Because I think the timing of this is critical. We have one of our board members, her name is Diane Withy, and we have for the last 6-7 months, she has gone out and to participate in grant writing workshops, grant notifications, to find out exactly what is required, both from a federal and a state level, in terms of for an organization like Experience Hampton to apply. And every organization, both federal and state, has come back and said, well, how much is it going to cost? What is going to be your bottom line in the application? And we can't answer that until we get this design. Now, we understand that our backs are against the wall from an organizational perspective to go and fit our idea into Chris's major idea. Mm-hmm. Because we also know that once he puts that road back together again, we missed our opportunity. But for us to be able to be involved in that opportunity, we need to get a price. And so we can't delay it till next year, because then it's going to be too late. So that's why we had made the decision, be at the last minute, but this is why we made the decision this year to go after that that warrant article.
Anybody else have questions?
Yeah, absolutely. Sunny has been trying to
get down
there.
Oh, I can't see Sunny. He's hidden.
All right.
Okay.
Say sidewalks. So I guess the town applied for a grant. They didn't get it. Yeah. The other thing is, I'm getting old. All right, that's it.
We're all getting old.
Oh, I know what it was. Unitil is showing profits bigger than they ever did because they're just buying power off the grid, you know, so they can be leaned on to spend a little money.
We're leaning. We've leaned a little bit already. There's more to do.
Madam Chairman, I just have one
more. I have to say, credit to Unitil. They've been very cooperative with us. They haven't stonewalled us. They've been very upfront. It's been a pleasure working with them.
Just have one more combination question and comment. If it's so critical and all that sort of thing, I'm amazed we haven't heard about this until tonight. First of all,
But second of all, if you want the public to be involved and vote yes on this, which I assume you do, then I suggest you get more information out to the public so they'll know what it means for which the town might be obligated with several million dollars warrant article coming up in the future, possibly if you can't get the grants and then you have to resort to the taxpayers. So I think it all ought to be out there available to the public more than it has been so far. That's my opinion, and I'm sorry if everybody thinks I'm picky on experience happened. I'm not doing that. I'm just saying this needs to be exposed to the public is what I'm saying. And we've made plans before which they've not pursued. Not saying that Experience Hampton's ever had any failures like that. I'm just saying that's happened for the town many times over the years. So I'm a little concerned about the lack of information for the public. Thank you.
And Mr. Pierce, one comment to that, and I think it's really important, and you bring up a good point. It is now behooves an organization like Experience Hampton and its membership to be able to now look at this, knowing that we have the majority support of the Board of Selectmen and hopefully the majority support of the Budget Committee. It behooves us as an organization to start tomorrow morning a campaign, a public information campaign. I am sure that in talking with the local businesses, they will be very supportive. The membership of Experience Hampton has a wide variety of contacts within the community, and we will tomorrow morning be starting an informational campaign. So not only at the deliberate session, but the day of the vote, I will have hoped that we have communicated fully what our intentions were behind this warrant article.
Okay, further questions before we call for the initial one? Oh, Brian.
If I like to be pro, if all these articles pass, are you going to have enough time to actually physically do all this? I mean, I have a second follow-up question, but.
Yes, because I have outside engineers that are actually going to be designing, permitting, and then inspecting each one of the projects. And only my daily visitation would necessarily be required. I also have, we have a new staff engineer in, mm-hmm. So I'm fully staffed. The second thing is the nature of the work, the replacement of the force main, the replacement of the sewer main on Lafayette Road, it's work that has to be done. It's like the repair of the roof, of our own homes. And sometimes we ask ourselves, do I have the time or the energy? It's necessary work. It cannot be avoided. The other thing is, I have a great staff, I have to admit, between the Frank Swifts, Al Jones, Russ Nickersons, all these people they have construction experience. And so it's not, well, we get it done, we have to get it done. And yeah, I'm confident that we can. We won't be overwhelmed.
How would you coordinate, again, being pro, with like Article 11 for the sidewalks? How are we going to deduct that from the overall?
No, I'm already out to solicitation for surveyors to survey this one section.
Right.
With the instruction that same surveyor is going to have to work with Unitil. It's going to have to work with Wright Pierce for the sewer. It's going to have to work with their information, maybe Ty and Bond, who's doing Aquarian's work, and whomever we select to do the complete streets design in the end, they're going to have to work with all of them. So coordination-wise, yeah, it's not abnormal for me.
Right.
We went to a meeting yesterday with Wright Pierce first thing in the morning, 8 o'clock, made a lot of design decisions right then and there. Be done with it, move on. And we're doing the same thing with the dam project and a host of other projects. So, no, we're used to it.
All right, thank you.
Yeah. And he's not allowed to go home at all. He just has to walk. Okay, anybody else on the Budget Committee with questions before I call for the vote prior to the public?
Yes. I think have a motion to make a recommendation for this?
We should do this at the end, no?
Well, we're in a public meeting now, and you can make a motion to recommend if you wish now, but I do have questions.
Yep.
So I don't care what order you take it in, Madam Chair.
Okay, well, I accepted a motion at 7:39 from Mr. Jones and Mr. LaBranche to recess our public hearing to address this. So until we have concluded asking questions, we will then go out of the recess into the public hearing. Mr. Jones, you have questions?
Yes. Chris, you've submitted for this warrant, depending on how you count them, anywhere between 7 and 9 warrant articles from your department. And this stunning last moment appearance of this warrant article as a private petition begs the question, why, if you so endorse it, why didn't you include it as one of your warrant articles as a department warrant article?
Just came forward.
Yeah, go ahead.
Excuse me, that question is directed to Chris, the DPW director.
As I said earlier, it's a multiple year project. I literally thought that we could cover this engineering and we had time. With all the digging that Experience Hampton did and all the meetings that we've had, we've met September, October, November, December. It was apparent 3 days ago that this needed to proceed forward now rather than later. What really substantially changed in the last several days is Experience Hampton coming up and saying that they would put up a portion of the money. Without that public-private partnership, you're right, I thought that I had enough on the table or had presented enough to the voters. But it's very timely to get this done. It is, others have stated, don't let this opportunity go by. To be honest with you, I presented to the Board of Selectmen over 13 million in articles.
Was this one of them?
No. As okay. We said 3 days ago.
So you presented an enormous list totaling $13 million, and the Board of Selectmen, using their prudent wisdom, narrowed it down to what was presented to us, right?
A number.
And of that enormous $13 million, it did not include this work, correct?
Correct.
All right. Now, you had mentioned that you were aware of this article before and worked with the wording on this one.
3 days ago.
3 days ago.
3 days ago.
3 days ago. When was this warrant article submitted, Regina? Oh, she's left the table, sorry.
I think it was Monday. I saw the article come in when I was at the town office. I think it was Monday?
Well, Madam Chair, I was actually at the selectmen's meeting in which they reviewed all their warrant articles Tuesday at 5 p.m. I don't recall this being one of them.
For the record, the article was submitted in on the 10th of January. Per the Town of Hampton handbook, page 14.
Yeah, what time of day was that?
It indicates, it indicates that in that handbook, page 14, that a warrant article has to be submitted in no later than Tuesday, the second Tuesday of January. It does not specify what time.
5 p.m.
It does not specify 5 p.m.
Madam Chair, I'm reclaiming the floor.
Yes.
I was at the 5 o'clock meeting on January 10th, the Board of Selectmen. All right. And although those who watch Channel 22 will often hear the town manager's report, him saying the last chance to get in the warrant article is on January whatever at 5 p.m. at the Selectmen's office. Yeah. We hear it every year, the same thing. All right. This year, when I was at the January 10th Board of Selectmen's meeting in which they reviewed the last-minute warrant articles, the town manager did point out that people have until midnight to actually submit them. Oh. I believe Mr. Selectman Waddle asked, well, where do they submit them to? And the town manager said, any one of you people, that is one of the selectmen, can receive them up till midnight of that time. So my question is still, actually, was this submitted prior to that selectman's meeting at 5 o'clock, or was it between 5 and midnight? That's all I'm asking.
It was received by Selectman Waddell at 7:53 p.m. that evening.
All right, so it was submitted after the Selectman's meeting, and that's what caused it to be voted by the Selectman over in the corner earlier this evening. Do I have that right, Jim? Anyone from the Selectman? And I see that the Selectman voted 3-1. Regina, you back?
Yes, that's correct.
Who was the one that opposed the warrant article?
Jim.
Selectman Waddell.
And I'm wondering, Madam Chair, if I could invite Selectman Waddell to regale us with his wisdom on why we would consider his point of view on this, as well as the points of view we've already heard on the pro side.
Mm-hmm. Good.
No.
And the answer is no. He doesn't want us to regale us up with his wisdom. So, Madam Chair, what we have here is a warrant article raising $300,000, and even if you take off the $30,000 so-called public-private partnership,
mm-hmm. Madam
it's
Chair,
still
I have a question.
$275,000, and it was submitted literally. I mean, you can't get much more last minute than that. I mean, 7:30 at night, after the Board of Selectmen had reviewed the so-called last-minute warrant articles. Thrown at us, we didn't even know it was here until we turned the page. There's been no consideration at all that we've had an opportunity to give to this warrant article, which may have been Selectman Waddell's objection to it. I don't really know, but even Chris, who had submitted $13 million in Department of Public Works warrant articles, which was subsequently pruned by the Board of Selectmen using their prudential wisdom on the general topic, even that enormous $13 million did not include this work. That's how important this work was considered by the DPW director through all this time. And as you just heard Chris say, well, he got inspired by, $30,000 maybe underwriting this exercise. And we're throwing out, $270,000 because we might get $30,000 in free money on work to a future project, which the town has not approved. This future project, it hasn't even been defined. So the town has not had a chance to approve the future project referenced in this warrant article, yet we're being asked to put in hundreds of thousands of dollars in investment in a future warrant article that we haven't, as a town, approved.
Madam Chair.
And once we get to the point of the future project being defined, the argument will then be, well, gee, we've already spent hundreds of thousands of dollars on this. Don't let that all go down the drain. Vote for this now defined future project.
Everyone knows how this game is going to get played out.
Make the investment now.
Madam Chair, I have the floor. I have signals that you realize that. Wait.
We know how this creepy crawly game of getting us down into these rows of investments that we might not make in one step, but if we baby step them down the road and convince them they've already spent hundreds of thousands, perhaps millions of dollars that would be wasted if you don't pass this, well, then they have a better chance. Just like we get these savings programs where we just throw money aside and say, oh, now we're going to take it out of there, and by the way, no tax impact because we already robbed you, we've already taxed you on that money. This last minute is absolutely absurd. It gives us no opportunity to properly deliberate nor ensure that this has been integrated with the other DPW work. And I'll say again, Chris put out $13 million in DPW warrant articles and didn't include this work at all. That's how important this is. I strongly urge you to vote no on this. I have no further questions or comment. Yes, Madam Chair.
Okay, Regina was asking, and then Brian, I think.
Thank you, Ms. Wilsley, thank you. I would like to note one thing on this warrant article.
Regina, get up by the mic.
This was a petition warrant article, so it was signed by 25 or more Hampton resident voters who believe that this is a worthwhile project. I believe that the director had stated why it came in late, because they had some realizations about it that occurred 3 days later. It was submitted to us, and as soon as the Board of Selectmen were in receipt of it, we voted on it, and we have recommended it. So it's a petition, so there is no reason, there is no need for the Budget Committee to even recommend the article. It's going to go forward onto the warrant. Thank you very much.
Okay, is somebody else down there have their hand up? Because I can't see very well down there. We're all, no? Anybody else over here? Questions? Okay, appearing to have run out of gas, I will accept the motion to either recommend or not.
Madam Chair, yes. I make a motion for Article 44, reconstruction of Lafayette Road, to recommend. That's my motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Okay, who?
Regina.
Chuck. Okay.
Chuck. Okay.
understand the intent of the motion. Ready? Okay, in favor of recommending, and I've got to write this down for Barbara, so just give me a minute to catch everybody. In favor of recommending, okay, I've got Barnes, Rage, I'm still on my left, Henderson. Okay, LaBranch, and Danielle, and Bridle.
Did I get
everybody now? I've got Barnes, yes. Rage, Henderson, LaBranch, Augustine, and Bridle.
Mr. Kravitz
as well. He's hiding behind all of you down there. Okay, opposed? Okay, I've got Pierce.
I will if she turns her head.
I can't hear you. Pierce, Lapham. Pluff. Jones. Mara. One, two, three, four, five.
Which list do you want?
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Which list do you want?
Well, I'm just trying to figure out if I'm getting everybody. I've got six and
we have eight, seven
nine,
here.
Ten, 11.
Seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Okay, I have seven, and then I have five. So that's two. Who isn't voting?
You.
Oh. Okay. Woolsey is opposed. Okay, so we've got 7-6. There you go. And I read all your names, so that's good. Now, I will accept a motion at whatever time it is.
Madam Chair, I so move that we close this.
The recess.
Or we return to the recess public hearing.
Yes.
In which we are discussing the brand new baby of Article 44, which is reconstruction of Lafayette Road.
Okay, second. We complete. You're doing what?
I'm seconding.
What are you seconding? What did he do?
The motion to go out of the recess.
Well, that's what I thought. He said he wanted to discuss more, but after we come out of the recess, we're not going to discuss anything.
We're coming out of the recess, entering public hearing.
Yes.
I'm making it one motion.
45.
Which may be taking too long because of confusion, so I shouldn't
absolutely
do that.
Absolutely.
Sorry.
And seconded by Bridle.
Right.
Contrite.
I am indeed.
Yes. Wait. Everybody is talking. Stop.
Point of order.
Okay, go ahead.
So, are we back in the public hearing?
We're back in the public hearing.
Okay. Madam Chair, I move Article 44.
Tim, we already did that.
We just did it.
No, not the public hearing.
But we're going to ask if anyone in the public
I originally moved this to the public hearing, correct, Jenny?
Yeah, correct.
Okay. And who seconded it?
I have,
Who seconded it when I made that motion?
Let's see, you did, I have you,
Does
I don't
Burns?
Know. No, this Jones and Bridle moved to come out of the recess, and Jones and LaBranch moved to go into the recess.
Right.
So
I would like to move Article 44.
Okay.
Reconstruction.
I did that, Tim. While we were still in the public hearing before, I did that.
Okay, who seconded?
I moved it to the public hearing.
Okay, seconded by Mr. Henderson with the original to go into
public hearing for consideration by these people, and as well to be considered read as written.
Ah. Yeah. Okay. Great.
That's
and
a modified,
Mr. Henderson
that's
seconded.
A modified
now that we're in the public hearing, if everyone has not fallen asleep, does anyone want to volunteer to come up and discuss with us questions, comments? Bless your hearts. Okay, then we will adjourn the public hearing at 8.
You need a motion to adjourn now?
Yes, sir.
I'll make a motion to adjourn at 8:26 p.m.
Second.
Okay, now the public hearing has concluded, but we're going to address the four articles that were addressed by the public.
Wait, Madam Chair, point of order.
Yes.
Point of order. So are we, the hearing is ended. So what are we in now?
We have to do public meeting again? We are in the public because we need to follow up, if necessary, on any of the articles that were addressed by members of the public.
What are the four articles, Madam Chair, you're alleging?
Wait a second, smile at me. We've got a little pile here. I know this nice gentleman. The school. Wait a minute. This is the school's in here. Ignore me. I'm making notes all over the place.
Madam Chair, we were asked to, somebody asked, I think, to reconsider Article 29, add windows to the children's room at the library.
Yes. Right.
Yeah. My question is, the chair said there were four, and I want to know what the list of four is.
What?
You said there were four articles that were spoken to.
I thought there were four. One of them is for Article 40. Oh, wait a minute. Nobody's spoken.
That's correct.
So we don't have to do that. Okay. We have the add windows to the library.
That's the only one I can think of.
Reconstruction of Lafayette Road, and that has been discussed.
And the only other one was the SAU 90.
That was the Catholic school. That was the school. So this is the windows. Article 29.
I'm going to make an attempt to reconsider Article 29. Make a motion.
Second.
Now, we had a tie on that.
Yes.
So we need
Mr.
someone
LaBranche
to
was
vote.
Not in the was not in the prevailing side, which is the rule. You have to be in the prevailing side to make a motion and second it. And so if you're not, you can't.
And there's no prevailing side because...
Well, there is a prevailing side. Those who voted in the negative prevailed.
Oh, okay.
How did they prevail when it came, the motion was made, and because it was a tied vote, there was no, it went in the opposite way?
Because that's how they won?
Because the wording wording was to recommend.
Right.
Yeah.
The tie failed.
Okay.
Yes. So therefore it became not recommended. Therefore, those who...
So, Mr. Jones, you're making the motion to reconsider the children's library and windows?
No, I am not. I have not been given any additional information between that vote and now.
Okay.
I'll make a motion to reconsider.
I haven't gotten redundant information. I haven't gotten any new information.
And I'll second it.
Wait a minute. I'm trying to write it down. Who's seconding Mr. Plott? Mr. Henderson. Okay. We now have a motion on the table to reconsider the Budget Committee's original recommendation on Article 29.
Who would move and second that?
Mr. Pluff moved and Mr. Henderson seconded.
Mr. Henderson was not on the prevailing side.
He only seconded.
You don't have to be on the prevailing side.
Yes, he was. You voted for that.
Yeah, they voted in the affirmative.
No, well, you voted. Who voted negative? Who wants to second Mr. Pluff's motion? Because I literally don't remember.
I voted in the affirmative.
We go to the original vote.
Yes.
Okay. Then there will be no review of this or a revote on Article 29.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Does so anyone? The democratic process.
All the side comments just interfere with the meeting. Before everyone flees the room in horror, have we any other business to transact except the MS 737? You got all the stuff from the school,
yep,
right?
Yep, it's gone.
Okay,
yep.
This is the official form to confirm the budget for the town of Hampton. It's an MS 37. Stop talking. The DRA requires this. Now, your signatures have to go on here. You print your name, and then you go ahead and sign on the right. Brian, your name has already been printed. You do them in the order that you see on here. I'm going to pass them down this way first. Sign. There's a first sheet and a second sheet. Some of you have to sign on the second sheet. Christy, help. On the MS-737, are these extra copies for the board, or do you need all these signed?
No, I just need the, I had a two-page
yes.
signature.
They've got that.
It had everyone's name on it.
Yes, and they've got that. What? And these are pass-outs for us, or what?
Madam Chair.
What?
This one's signed, too.
No, that's the one that tells you who signs where.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
I believe we've concluded our business and moved to adjourn at 8:32.
And I just don't want everybody leaving until they sign.
Right, I agree with that. Can I get a second on my adjournment, please?
I will second that adjournment.
Thank you, Mr. Lowe.
Okay, wait a second. I've got to mark it down. Do not leave until you sign the MS-737.
Madam
you know
Chair, are we adjourned? Oh, we
that was Jones and who?
LeBrand.
Okay.
All in favor of adjourning?
Hold on! All right. The motion by Mr. Jones, seconded by Mr. LeBranch. At 8:32 p.m. is for this committee to adjourn the public hearing. In favor?
No, the public meeting, Madam Chair.
A public meeting. Public meeting. We're lucky we know what we're doing. Yes. Who's doing? Brian, are you happy to adjourn?
I'm happy.
Sunny, everybody happy?
Yeah, happy.
You?
Yeah.
We're happily unanimous.
Excellent.
See how we do it? See how soft
we have to sign this.